In today's video, we will discuss what is statistics and its type. If you are interested, then keep on watching. Hey champions, welcome back to this channel. Hope you're not spending a lot of time in your comfort zone, as great things never came from comfort zones. Get up and start hustling. With today's video, we are starting a new series via which we will try to make some important statistical concepts easier for you. You can subscribe to this channel for more such videos. If you're keen on learning Python, then we already have few Python videos up on our channel and a dedicated playlist for you to enjoy. The link is in the description box. Without any further delay, let's get started with the video. In today's video, we will be discussing what is statistics, what is a population, what is a sample, properties of a sample, what do you mean by sampling, types of sampling, some differences between a population and a sample, types of statistics. Now let us start with the most basic yet one of the important questions, and that is, what is statistics? It is the discipline that deals with the collection, analyzing, interpretation and presentation of data. I'm quite sure that this definition will sound quite complex at first glance, but let us try to break it down into simpler pieces so that you fully understand it. First, focus on the keyword discipline, which means that the statistics is a branch of knowledge or field of study. Some say that statistics is a branch of mathematics, just like probability theory and geometry, while some consider it to be a distinct mathematical science rather than a branch of mathematics. We cannot pick a side for now, but statistics for sure uses a lot of mathematical concepts to draw inferences from the data. Next, let us focus on the keyword collection. Data collection in general is a process of gathering and measuring information in an established and systematic fashion. Let us try to understand this step by example. When you open your credit card statement, you can see all the transactions made by you in a particular month are given in a tabular format. This is the step where the bank has collected data about your date of purchase, vendor, spend, and location on your behalf. Next, focus on analyzing. Analysis is a process of inspecting, cleaning, transforming, and modeling data to discover useful information, make conclusions, and support decision making. As per our previous example, this is the step where you categorize your spendings into various buckets such as necessities, wants, investments, etc. Here, your goal is to analyze the amount spent on these categories in a particular month. This analysis will help you to make an informed decision from next month. Next, focus on interpretation and presentation. It is the process of using graphs and visuals to represent data so that an informed decision can be made based on them. Here, as per our previous example, you create a bar chart or a donut chart to visualize your spending patterns. I hope understanding the keyword made the definition easier for you to understand. Now, there's another definition of statistics, and that is, a statistics is a characteristic of a sample, a parameter is a characteristic of a population. Now, to understand this definition, we must first understand what exactly a sample and a population is. First, let us see what a population is. It is a collection of individuals or objects or events whose properties are to be analyzed. In simpler words, the complete data collected for a study or an experiment. It is the data of an entire group. The definition only did half of the explaining job, but some examples will clear all our doubts. The population of interest can be all eligible voters in a country, all the trees in a particular country, or all the accounts receivable of a certain firm. As you can see, a population can be quite large. Rarely do we collect data of all the members of a population. It is very time consuming and expensive, but we still need to be able to make conclusion about the entire population. Here comes the sample. It is a representative subset of a population. That is, it is a small part or quantity intended to show what the whole population is like. For example, a slice from a cheesecake is a sample, while the whole cake is a population. The purpose of taking a sample is to learn something about the population from which it is selected. It goes without saying that there is no point in taking a sample if the population and its characteristics are known. Also remember, in almost all cases, samples from the same population should be independent of each other, as it makes no sense to have overlapping or repeating samples to infer about population. Some properties of a sample must be kept in mind while collecting them. First, that the sample should be representative of the population, meaning that the sample should accurately represent the whole population. It should be an unbiased reflection of what the population looks like. For example, if our population is student in a particular class that contains both boys and girls, but the sample taken from the class only contains girls from that class, then our sample is not representative because our sample does not share the same characteristics of a larger population. Since the sample is not accurately representing the population, Hence, we cannot generalize the result of our study to the population. That is, we cannot make a broader statement on the whole class based on our results from the sample. The second property of a sample is that it should be random. A sample is called random when each member of the subset has an equal probability of being chosen. It means that a sample should be an unbiased representation of the larger population. An example is a lottery method where each member of the population is assigned a number, after which numbers are selected at random. Since it is random, each person has an equal chance of winning the lottery. There is yet another important concept which is known as sampling. The process of drawing samples from the population is known as sampling. Sampling techniques are broadly classified into two types, probability sampling and non-probability sampling. First is probability sampling, where samples are chosen based on the probability theory. Some of the probability samplings are simple random sampling, cluster sampling, systematic sampling, and stratified random sampling. Next is non-probability sampling, where samples are chosen based on the researcher's subjective judgment. Some of the non-probability samplings are convenience sampling, judgmental sampling, snowball sampling, and quota sampling. Coming back to our original topic where we discussed that a statistics is a characteristic of a sample, a parameter is a characteristic of a population. A characteristic of a population or a sample can be its demographics. For example, if our population is all the people living in a specific country, then their age structure, birth and death rates, GDP are few characteristics that we may want to investigate. The characteristics changes with the population type. Hence, a study of a sample and the process of drawing inferences from it about the population all comes under the branch of statistics. Here are top 4 reasons why we should choose a sample over a population. First, sample collection is more practical. In most cases, it is not practical to collect complete data about the population as it can be too large. Samples offer a representation of the whole population and they are easier to collect as well. Second is time consuming. Surveying a smaller sample as opposed to the entire population saves time. Third is cost effective. Surveying a representative sample of a population is more cost effective as compared to surveying the whole population. In the case of sample, it requires fewer resources like computers, researchers, interviewers, servers, and data collection centers. Fourth and the last reason is that it is manageable. Sometimes collecting and storing the complete data about a population is nearly impossible. In such a case, a sample can be used to represent the study as it is feasible, manageable, and accessible. Now moving on to the next topic, which is population versus sample. First, population data is a complete set, while the sample is a subset of the population that is derived using sampling. Second is that the measurable characteristic of the population is known as the parameter, while the measurable characteristic of a sample is called a statistic. Third is that the collection of population data is more time-consuming, less cost-effective, and less manageable, while the collection of sample data is less time-consuming, more cost-effective, and more manageable. The last difference is that the population parameters are used directly in the analysis, while the sample statistics is used to infer details about the population in the analysis. The next topic on our list is type of statistics. There are broadly two types of statistics. First is descriptive statistics. As the name suggests, this type of statistics is concerned with describing, summarizing, and graphing the data. That is, it involves summarizing a large amount of data so that it is easier to interpret by giving short summaries about the data. In this type of statistics, we generally do not reach a conclusion or a proof of hypothesis, but just describe and summarize the data. It can be done on both the sample and the whole data. Generally, descriptive statistics are used to present quantitative description in a manageable form. There are three types of descriptive statistics. The first type is the distribution that concerns the frequency of each value. The second type is the measure of central tendency, which analyzes the averages of the values. It can be further divided into mean, median, and mode. And the third type is the measure of variability or dispersion that concerns how spread out the values are. They are further divided into variance, standard deviation, range, and z-score. Next type of statistics is inferential statistics. As the name suggests, this type of statistics is used to draw inferences or conclusion about the population from the sample data. Inferential statistics is quite opposite to descriptive statistics, as the latter is solely concerned with the property of the observed data, and it does not rest on the assumption that the data comes from a larger population, while the former works on the assumption that the sample data is a subset of the larger population. Sample data is used in the inferential statistics. All the cool machine learning models come under this type of statistics. Some examples of this type of statistics are hypothesis testing, probabilities, regression, correlation, and machine learning models. That's it for today's video. I hope the video helped you understand what is statistics and its type. You can share your thoughts or questions in the comment box. Subscribe for more such videos. Bye, and meet you in the next one.